Hello Year 4 and welcome to Friday's Maths. Now today we are going to be ordering amounts of money. So for Discover we have Isla here, and Isla is looking at a lot of items for sale, and they're for sale for different prices. We have the football for £5, the teddy bear for 505p, the pencils for 75p, this comic book for £5.75, this keyboard £7.50, and this notebook for 50p. Now, A, you need to put the items in order from least expensive down to most expensive. And which items could Isla buy with the money that she has? Now, Isla has £5. So put the items in order from least to most expensive. And which items could Isla buy with the money that she has? Have a go. Okay, let's go through it. So you were asked to put these items in order of least expensive to most expensive, and to find out which items Isla could buy with the £5 that she has. So what they've suggested you do, because all of these items are in different, are being represented in different ways, we have pounds, we have pence, we have pounds and pence, they've suggested that you convert all of these amounts into pence. Then, what this young lady has done is she's put them on a number line, okay? So she decided that the least expensive was the notebook with 50p, okay? Then it will be the colouring pencils for 75p. And then we go all the way up to the football here. Now the football here is £5, but we know that there's 100p in a pound. This football is 500p. Then the teddy bear at 505p. Then this video game or comic book, which is £5.75 here, but here we've got 575p. And finally, the keyboard, 750p or £7.50. Okay, so it's notepad, pencils, football, teddy bear, computer game, and then keyboard. Now, Isla has a £5 note. So the items that Isla could buy could cost £5 or 500p or less than that, but she only has £5 or 500p to spend. She can't spend any more than that. So she could buy the football because that's exactly £5, or she could buy the pencils, 75p, and she could buy the notebook as well for that price. Okay, so she could buy this, the football, or she could buy these two together for her £5. She couldn't buy the teddy bear. Even though it says 500p in it, it is more than 500p. It's 505p. So she's 5p short by the teddy bear. Okay, think together. So this is very similar to that first question you did where you had to order the prices of things. So we have a dinosaur comic for 59p, a doll for 5.99, a car for 99p, a train for £9.95, and a film for 595p. Now, your jobs are, which is the cheapest item on the shelf? That means cheapest means it costs the least amount. Which is the most expensive item on the shelf? So it costs the most. Then you need to order the items from the least expensive to the most expensive, and finally order the items from the most expensive to the least expensive. You have a number line here to give you a hand, and they've already started with one in place. Okay, have a go. Okay, let's have a look, shall we? So, first of all, which item is the cheapest on the shelf? Well, that would be the dinosaur comic at 59p. Okay? Which is the most expensive item? Well, I'm looking at the pounds now. That one has no pounds. This one has no pounds. This one has £5. This one has £9. And this one has 595 pence. Now I know that 500 pence is going to be £5. So the most expensive of those three is the train at £9.95. Okay, so it's the train. C, order the items from the least to the most expensive. So we've got the least expensive with the dinosaur comic. Next up is the car, still £0 but 99 pence. Then we have the film for 595 pence. Now that's £5 and 95 pence. Then the doll for £5 and 99 pence. And finally the train for £9 and 95 pence. Now D, we need to order these items from the most expensive to the least expensive. So we flip them round. The train, down to the doll, to the film, to the car, to the dinosaur comic. Okay? Now, think together too. We're back with these items here. And Alex has these coins here. Your task is, which of the toys could Alex buy? If Alex wanted to buy any of these toys, which ones could he buy for this amount of money? Okay, have a go. Okay, let's have a look. So, I counted this money. That's £2, that's £2, that's £1, that's £1, and that's 50p. So, Alex has £2, £4, £5, £6, and 50p. Alex has £6.50. So which of the toys could Alex buy? Well, they have to be less than or the same as this amount of money. So they have to be the same or less than £6.50. So could buy the dinosaur comic because that's 59 pence. Could buy the doll because that's £5.99 and that's less than £6.50. Could buy the car, because that's 99 pence and that's less than £6.50. Now, could Alex buy the train? Well, the train is £9.95. Alex only has £6.50, so the train costs more than what Alex has. So Alex can't buy the train, but Alex can buy the film because it's 595 pence and we've already said that's £5.95. So Alex could buy the dinosaur comic, the doll, the car, or the film. And finally, challenge. Now, if you've finished your practice book work, come back and take a look at the challenge if you feel up to it.